Hi, Dr. Kandula with Advent. Today, talking about what doesn't mix very well with sleep apnea, which is basically sleeping pills. The reality is if somebody's taking a sleeping pill, what that pill is doing is sort of depressing their function. Alcohol is not a medication that is sold by a pharmacist, but alcohol is also a depressant. And so I think anybody who has a tendency to snore, anybody who has sleep apnea, if you have a drink or two and you go to sleep, the snoring is going to be worse, the sleep apnea is going to be worse. So that kind of is a real world example of what happens when you take a depressant before you go to sleep at night. Many sleeping pills are depressants as well, and so it's a really, really bad combination. So if somebody has sleep apnea, their throat is too tight. When they lay down, their throat becomes so tight that their throat shuts. Sleep apnea is something that's massively underdiagnosed. So many people have sleep apnea and they don't know they have it. Because they find a reason not to go to do a sleep study, even though sleep studies are so simple to do these days. So the reality is most people in this country who have sleep apnea are not currently getting treated. Something that can coexist with sleep apnea is insomnia. Insomnia is different than sleep apnea. Insomnia is when you have a hard time falling asleep at night. And that can be a problem. Unfortunately, a lot of people chase their insomnia with pills and alcohol and other things. Now, the problem is, if you think about this, what I just said, if you have sleep apnea, when you lay down to sleep at night, you strangle yourself internally, you can't breathe, your body doesn't like that, although you don't know that that's happening necessarily. So what ends up happening is you train your brain to associate sleep with trying to die at night, which is not a good association. So your brain says, I don't want to go to sleep. That's called insomnia. So what ends up happening is your brain and your body become anxious with the thought of sleep, and they try to keep you awake and they say, don't go to sleep. And so if you chase that insomnia with a sleeping pill, you're walking right into, into the lion's den there, which is not something you want to do. So I think from a sleep standpoint, if there is a tendency at all for snoring, stopping breathing, if you've had a sleep study that says you do have sleep apnea and you've chosen not to do something about it, the wrong thing to do is to grab a bottle of sleeping pills and think that that's going to solve the problem. It's not. It's going to make the problem worse. And so what I would recommend is if you have any signs or symptoms of sleep apnea is to seek out treatment for that sleep apnea, because what we find is if we treat that underlying sleep apnea for folks who have sleep apnea and insomnia, oftentimes that insomnia magically kind of finds its way gone. Really, drugs of any sort and sleep apnea don't mix, and I wouldn't do it. And so if you're thinking about doing that, or you do or are doing that, stop. And if you think you've got an issue, I'd say find out what's going on, and likely if there is that sleep apnea issue going on, there's going to be multiple better options or actual options than grabbing a bottle of pills. So that's all I got. Take care.